Hello, my name is Abdo Durra. I am at Dr. Gomperts Lab here at UCLA. Here I work with the lab and my lab members to study the disease called idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis. And we're trying to develop a new model for it to understand what it is and find ways to cure it. So here in the lab, we study a disease called idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis. And if you divide the three words in the disease name, idiopathic means of unknown origin. So we don't know what causes this disease. Pulmonary is relating to the lungs. And then fibrosis is scarring or hardening of the tissue. I come from a very rural village in Syria, which is a small country in the Middle East. I grew up there in the village, and we had like farms and stuff, and I always was curious. My dad was a biology teacher at the high school in the village, and he always fed up my curiosity. And then later on in life, we migrated here to the United States, and I went to high school, and then later on, I went to a university, studied biology, just following my dad's footsteps. I became interested in science since I was young. In my village where I grew up, we had a lot of crops and farms, and there was one point in time where there's a disease that's affecting all the farms in the area. So they called people from the city, they came and they started taking samples from the trees, and they took it out to their labs and analyzed it, and then give all the farmers medicine to treat the plants. And since that moment, I remember like everyone was happy and like how science helped cure this disease and helped all the farmers. So from that moment on, I became interested in science. I was motivated to come into research that studies diseases because idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis, which is the disease we study, has unknown origin and there is no cure for it. So it has a lot of mysteries around it. And I thought coming into this lab and contributing to this research will be helpful for a lot of people now and in the future. So when we get the samples from people that have the disease, we look at these cells. We look to see what kind of phenotype or what kind of pattern they have that this disease is known for. And then after that, when we develop our own model, we grow these cells and we put them in an incubator. And an incubator keeps the temperature similar to our body temperature and the same percentages of gases, same as the air we breathe. And then we grow these cells and look under the microscope to match the characteristics of these cells with the cells that we got from the patients that have the disease. And then after that, we try to analyze the different factors or proteins that are in the cells to understand the biology of the disease. So everyone in the lab has their own project, but because all the projects are related to each other, every week we meet together and we share the data that we collected and try to understand it all together in the essence of the disease we're studying. So I get some data, my friend gets some data, and then even though we are working on separate projects, they're all connected to the same disease or to the same organ. So once we have these data together, when we meet, everyone collaborates with each other to understand this data and make sense of it. So my ultimate dream is to have my own lab. And in order to do that, I have to go into graduate school, which can be either PhD in biology or medical school to be a doctor. And once you have your own lab, you can work on anything you want, any idea or any disease that you want to test or find a cure of. So if you're pursuing a career in STEM fields, so it's science, technology, engineering, or mathematics, I feel you shouldn't be disappointed or shouldn't be discouraged if you didn't do good in high school or if you didn't do good in university. Because even though it sounds hard, if you put your mind to it, it's not that hard. And it's very important for people, especially now, to go into STEM fields because this is what's going to help us in the future and bring our humanity to higher and higher levels. We're all born curious. And scientists that you see around, they're all like normal people. I mean, there's nothing that's that special. They're not super smart. They're not very geniuses that have to be a scientist. I mean, you don't have to have one kind of personality that it's like one size fits all to be a scientist. Everyone can be a scientist.